Okay, so now let's try this sample problem here. A 200-pound block has an impending motion up a 30-degree inclined plane caused by a horizontal force of 400 pounds. Determine the coefficient of static friction. So we have some choices here. So to answer this problem, first we have to draw the block that was being described in the problem. So we have an inclined plane, which is this, which is inclined at a degree of 30 degrees. And then we have this block of wood or some arbitrary block with a weight, according to the problem, equals to 200 pounds. Okay, so of course, the weight is always acting at the center, or more precisely at the centroid of the block, centroid or center of gravity. Okay, so the block of wood, according to the problem, has an impending motion up the incline. So being kumbaga konting-konti na lang mag-move na yung block up the incline, pataas. Bakit? Kasi there is a horizontal force, which is this, with a magnitude of 400 pound being applied to the block of wood. So if you can imagine, if you are pushing a block of wood horizontal, using a horizontal force like this, if you can imagine, the block of wood will tend to move upwards, up the incline, up the incline plane. Okay. So the question just asks for the coefficient of static friction, which is the mu, or mu sub s. Okay, so first thing to do here for us to solve the problem, of course, is to draw the free body diagram, which is this. Although this free body diagram is not somehow complete, because there are some other forces that act on the block that must be drawn here. So aside from these forces, we need to put here some other forces that also act on the block. Okay, but for better computation, it's best to provide the axis of the forces along the plane and perpendicular to the plane. So we will use this axis, which we will call as a t-axis, and as well as this axis, which is what we call a normal axis in our computation. So whenever you are computing a problem similar to this, you can use a technique wherein you are rotating the axis or the axis at some degree for your convenience. Okay, so here on this problem, for convenience, instead of using a horizontal and a vertical axis, we will just use this axis parallel to the inclined plane, as well as this axis perpendicular to the inclined plane for easy computation. Okay, so yung 400 pound, if we will be referring its angle with respect sa t-axis, which is parallel to the inclined plane, obviously, since this is 30 degrees, obviously, this is also 30 degrees. Okay? And this angle, since this is 30 degrees, and this whole angle is 90 degrees, therefore, ito ay 60. So, if this is 60 degrees, this is perpendicular as well. Yung 200 pound tsaka 400 pound perpendicular din with each other. Eh. So, kung 60 degrees to, ano to? This is also 30 degrees. Okay? So, we have referred the angles of the 400 and the 200 pound forces with respect to the T and N axis respectively. Okay? So, aside from those forces, we also have this force acting on the block, which is perpendicular to the inclined plane. And that force is actually what we call the normal force. So take note, normal force is always acting perpendicular to the plane or to the surface where the body is resting. Okay? And aside from that, we also have this force acting along the surface of the plane, which is what we call the friction force. Okay? So again, friction force is always directed opposite the direction of motion. So since on this particular problem, the block is has an impending motion up the incline, ibig sabihin pataas yung motion ng block due to the application of the 400 pound force, definitely the direction of the friction force will be opposite the up direction of the incline. So the friction force will be directed downwards, okay, just like what you are seeing here. Okay, so using the conditions of equilibrium, since the motion is just impending, so when we say impending motion, wala pa talagang motion, kumbaga going there pa lang, malapit pa lang mag-move, malapit pa lang magkaroon ng motion, pero wala pa talaga totally motion. So if there is no motion sa problem na to or sa block na to, therefore dapat yung summation ng forces along the TN axis must be equal to zero. So meaning wala siyang tendency to move along this direction tsaka along this direction. Okay, so if we will be summing up forces along the normal direction or normal axis, their sum must be equal to zero. So assuming na yung mga pagganon na force according here ay positive, so let's sum up forces along the N axis. So let's start with N. So yung N directed along ganun na direction according here, positive yung ganun. So positive yung sign natin dito. Okay? Yung N component, kumbaga, ni 400 pound, which is directed here. So pag ganito yung N component ni 400 pound, obviously, yan, pag ganyan. Or I'll just change the color so that it will be more visible. This is the Y component or N component of 400 pound. And how do we get that N component? So since the angle here is referred to the T axis, we can just simply multiply 400 pound by sine 30, sine ng angle na to. So pag kumbaga parang ito yung x axis dyan tsaka y axis eh, di ba? Nanerotate mo lang. So paano makuha yung y component? Sine lang ng angle. Okay? So ang direction nun is pag ganito, and sabi natin yung pag ganun yung positive, so negative yung nilagay natin dito na sine. Okay? In addition to that, we also have this N component of the 200 pound force. Okay? So yung N component niya or kumbaga Y component niyan para makuha, since yung angle is naka-refer sa Y axis or sa N axis, instead of multiplying this by sine, we multiply this 200 pound by cosine of the angle, which is 30 degrees. And since this is directed downwards, or should I say, since this is directed on this direction, opposite this, so the sine must be negative. Okay, so according to this, their sum must be equal to zero. Okay, that's your first equation. The second equation can be coming from this relationship. So the summation as well of the forces along the t-axis, assuming that yung mga forces na paganito ay positive, must all be equal to zero. So sum up natin yung mga forces along t-axis, and recall lang na ang friction force is equal to mu n, or specifically mu sub s n, since the impending pa lang naman yung motion, wala pang motion, so mu sub s pa yung gagamitin natin, or yung coefficient of static friction. Okay, so summing up forces along t-axis, let's start with the x component of the 400 pound na force. So I'll just write it down here. So yung x component or yung t component ni 400 pound force obviously is this. And how do we get the t component or the x component? Multiply lang yung 400 pound sa cosine ng angle. Okay, since dito naman naka-refer yung angle. While yung t component or x component ni 200 pound force is this. So paano makuha yan? Since yung angle ay naka-refer sa n or y axis, sine naman. Okay, 200 pound sine ng angle. And since pakaliwa siya, kumbaga opposite this, negative yung sine niya. Okay, aside from those two forces, we also have this force directed along the t-axis, which is equal to F. And again, F is equal to mu n or mu sub s n. So ang direction niya is pag ganito, so opposite this, so negative. Okay? Okay, so wala nang other forces directed along the t-axis other than them. So ang sum nila dapat equal to 0 according to this equation. Okay, so we have this two equations with two unknowns. And what are the unknowns? N and mu sub s. Okay, so since we have two equations, two unknown, we can simply calculate yung mga unknown dyan using your calculator mode 5.1, yung two equations, two unknown. Or you can just simply express this in terms of n and then substitute the corresponding value here. So, ang nawawala na lang sa equation na to will be mu sub s. So, solving for mu sub s will be equal to 0.66. Okay, so the correct answer here is letter D, 0.66. Okay, so other solution for this problem is this. Okay, so copying this free body diagram, we have this. Okay, so instead of using the components, friction force and the normal force, we can simply get their resultant and we will call that as R, which is directed at an angle equal to V. Okay, so instead of using N and F, we can also use their resultant na lang. Okay, so yung R is obviously the resultant of F and N, and that is directed at an angle V with respect sa normal force as we have discussed before. Okay, so since resultant na yung nandito, and again, yung resultant is a single force that can already represent this components, therefore, we can already remove them. So, iwan na lang natin yung resultant. Okay, so from here, from this free body diagram, composed of this force, this, and this, which is directed at a certain angle phi from the n-axis, we can now solve for the corresponding values of r and phi. Okay, using the conditions of equilibrium, yung summation of forces n, tsaka t. So that is another solution. Okay, so using this free body diagram and using the shortcut, so this is just a shortcut, guys, but the normal way to compute this is apply again this and this on this free body diagram. Okay, so what will just happen is you will just change n here by the component of r along n. So this is the component of r along n. So how do we get that component? So since yung angle natin is naka-refer sa n axis or sa y axis, yung y component will be r cosine ng phi, while the x component or the t component will be r sine phi. So you will just have to change yung n dito. You will just have to change your n ng r cos phi, and then yung mu sub s n, you just have to change it to r sine phi. Okay, so you still have two unknowns there, r and phi. Okay, you can just do some manipulations of the equations so to us to be able to compute for the value of r and phi. Okay, so once makuha mo na yung value ng isa dyan, makuha mo na yung value ng other. Okay, but for shortcut purposes, we can simply express these forces. So I'll just remove the components. You can simply express these three forces in their polar form so that you can easily use the calculator, the mode 5.2 or the complex mode of the calculator. So we can just express these forces in terms of their polar form, starting with the 400-pound force. So yung polar form is a form in this format, R angle theta, wherein yung R is yung magnitude ng force, and then yung theta niya is the angle of the force referred to the positive x-axis. So in this case, ito yung positive axis natin. Dito natin i-refer lahat ng angles. Okay, so yung 400 pound, of course, yun yung R, yun yung na yung R niya, yung magnitude niya. Yung angle niya, para malaman nyo yung angle niya, you can just imagine yung 400 pound somewhere here. So iusog lang natin yung 400 pound. Okay, so since this is 30, since angle na to is 30, this is also 30 degrees. Okay, but since that is measured clockwise, we will put a negative sign on that angle. Since sabi nga natin last time, ang mga angles that are measured pag ganito are positive. Otherwise, kung pabaligtad, negative. Okay, that's why negative yung nilagay natin dito. Okay, and then next, yung 200 pound, express natin sa molar form, yeah? So, yung R will be the 200 pound itself. And then, yung angle ng 200 pound, para ma-imagine nyo kung ano yung angle ng 200 pound na yan, we can just simply move the 200 pound here para mas madali nyo siyang ma-imagine. So, yan yung 200 pound. This is 30 degrees. So, obviously, this is also 30 degrees. Okay? But what we need is itong angle na to na naka-refer sa positive x-axis. So, paano makuha yung angle na yan? Okay? So, yung angle na yan can be computed by adding 180 degrees to this angle, which is obviously 60 degrees. Pwedeng ganon. Okay? Or pwede rin naman, eto na lang yung angle na kunin natin. So, either way, parehas lang naman yung lalabas sa sagot. Tama naman yan. Okay? Tama naman parehas yan. Ang goal lang natin dito, guys, is yung angle dapat palaging naka-refer sa positive x-axis or positive t-axis, which is this. So, regardless kung paano ikot niya pa-counterclockwise or pa-clockwise, okay lang yan. As long as dito siya naka-refer. Okay, so pwedeng ito na lang yung gamitin natin na angle. So, this is 90 degrees plus 30 degrees. 90 plus 30, tapos i-negative lang natin since pa-clockwise yung ikot niya. Okay, lastly, yung R, which is this. Yung R, which is this, kung imo-move natin siya dito para mas madali natin siyang ma-imagine kung ano yung angle, this is phi. If this angle is phi, obviously, itong angle na to, phi is the angle between the n-axis and the r. Okay? Or simply, kung ito yung n-axis and then ito yung r. So, yung magiging angle na to will be the phi. Okay? So, referring the angle of r with respect dito sa positive x-axis, what we need is this whole angle. And that whole angle is obviously 90 degrees plus phi, which is this. Okay, so this will be our equation. Okay, so ang sum na niyang mga yan, according sa equations of equilibrium, dapat equal to zero for this system of force to be balanced. Okay, so kung i-compute nyo sa calc yan, you can compute this term here sa calc. Okay, so using mode 5.2. Okay, pag na-compute nyo na yan, you can just move it to the right side of the equation. So, ini-negative nyo lang whatever value you computed or resulted on your calculator. Ini-negative nyo lang yon. Tapos, i-convert nyo lang sa polar form. So, i-ano nyo ulit, i-R angle theta. Gawin nyo ulit na ganitong form yung sagot. Kasi usually, naka-rectangular form yun eh. So, i-pindutin nyo lang sa calculator nyo. Hanapin nyo lang yung polar form. So, lalabas na to. Okay, so, ibig sabihin yan, yung R angle 90 plus phi, which will be the remaining term here sa left side, is just equal to this, which is the result of simplifying this in your calculator and moving to the right side, so in a negative. Okay, so ito yung magiging result. So, ang ibig sabihin lang nito, yung R, ang magnitude niya is 447. Okay, yung magnitude nito, that is 447.21. And then, yung 90 plus phi is equal to 123.43. Okay? So, since yung 90 plus phi is equal to 123.43, we can easily compute for phi. So, i-minus mo lang sa 123 yung 90. Okay? And after computing for phi, recall lang na ang tangent ng phi is equal to u sub s, as we have discussed from the previous discussion. Okay? So, therefore, tangent ng phi, which is 123.43 minus 90, is equal to mu sub s. Simplifying this to your calculator, the answer will still be 0.66. Okay, obviously, 0.66 pa rin naman talaga dapat kasi nga other solution lang naman to. Okay,